Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we are going to take up another current affair, that is the comparison of Indian economy with that of Chinese economy. If you remember, the last day we compared the military capacity or the defense capacity of India and China. And today in this lecture, we will be taking up the comparison of the economies. So economy in the sense that the economic activities, the size of the economy, etc. So let's see, in this Asia region, India and China are the two emerging economies, and also in many factors, Asia is seen as the next upcoming regional power, and this is because of the two countries, India and China. So we can say that India and China has together given this title to Asia as the upcoming regional power as well. So we will be discussing the economy of both these countries. We will be comparing the economies of both these countries in detail in this lecture. So let's begin. But before that, this is our channel, and please do subscribe to our channel if you have not yet subscribed, and press the bell icon for getting notifications. And also we are providing online coaching for GATE, NTA, UGC, UGC NET and PGT Computer Science. So you can avail our online courses for your preparations. And for more details, please do visit our website www.digimento.com, or you can call to this number for getting more details about the courses that we provide. So let's come to the topic. Let's come to the comparison of Asia and China and India. Let's see how these economies are important, and also let's compare the capacities of these economies. So among the Asian countries, China and India together, they contribute more than half of Asia's GDP. That is why these two countries play a very, very important role in the Asia region. So both these economies, that is India and China, China and India, they play a very important role in the region. Region here refers to the Asia region. And together these two countries, they contribute more than half, that is more than 50% of Asia's GDP, which means these are the two important countries in the Asia region, the most important countries in the Asia region. And with these two countries in this Asia region, Asia region has got the tag of upcoming regional power. So this is again very important. Now, China and India are two emerging economies in the world. So these countries are known as or categorized under the title EMEs or emerging market economies. So EMEs or emerging market economies. So China and India are two emerging economies in the world. Emerging means those economies which will soon add to the list of developed countries. As of 2019, China and India is second and the fifth largest country of the world respectively in nominal basis. So second and the fifth largest country on nominal basis. Nominal means nominal GDP. So GDP at nominal level. Now on PPP basis, PPP means purchasing power parity, and PPP or purchasing power parity means that you are comparing the capacity of one country's currency with that of other in terms of its purchasing power. Now for example, rupees and dollar if you take. So under PPP, what we consider is, suppose there are some quantities, let's say for example XYZ quantities of commodities which can be purchased using $10. So here we are comparing how much quantity or how much quantity of commodities can be purchased with that of rupees, which is equivalent to $10. This is what we compare in the purchasing power. So purchasing power parity refers to the ability of a country to purchase a particular quantity of a commodity using their particular currency. So China is the first and India is at the third place in terms of PPP or purchasing power parity. So China is first and India is third. And both the countries, they together share 19.46 and 27.18 of total global wealth in nominal and PPP terms respectively. Now, in 1987, the GDP nominal of both the countries was almost equal. So, this is very important. Why? Because during our discussion, most of the times from examination perspective or for analysis purpose also, what is important? In 1987, both the countries' GDP was almost equal. But how did China go far ahead of India? So, this is one question that we need to answer. And for that, we need to know from when is the difference happening. So, till 1987, in terms of nominal GDP, both the countries had almost equal GDP. But in 2019, China's GDP is almost 4.78 times greater than India. So, 33 years. Within a span of 33 years, China has grown almost 5 times than that of India in terms of GDP. 4.78, close to 5 times. So, we need to understand why China has gone so much ahead of India within this short period of time. On purchasing power parity basis, GDP of China is 2.38 times that of India. And China has crossed $1 trillion trade mark in 1998, while India crossed 9 years later, that is in 2007, at exchange rate basis. So, this shows that at a time, that is in 1987, both the countries in terms of economic growth is measured in terms of GDP. Both the countries had almost equal GDP. And what are the factors responsible for the growth of China as compared to India? And what are the factors that took India backwards as compared to China? So, this is one question as an Indian we should all be aware about. Now, let's come to GDP per capita. So, here we will be making the comparisons. Both the countries have been neck to neck in GDP per capita terms. So, GDP per capita. So, what is meant by GDP per capita? GDP per capita is national income or GDP, rather we can say GDP divided by population. So, this is GDP per capita. Okay. GDP divided by population. So, in case of GDP per capita terms, both the countries are neck to neck. And as per both method, India was richer than China in 1990. So, in 1990, we were richer than China. Now, in 2019, China is almost 4.61 times richer than India in nominal method and 2.30 times richer in PPP method. So, what happened? Where did India go wrong? And what are the opportunities that China grabbed? Now, per capita rank of China is 65th and India is 139th in the nominal GDP calculation. So, in terms of per capita GDP, China has a global position of 65, whereas India has 139. Now, can you tell me, even when we have one of the largest GDPs in the world, why is the per capita GDP very less? This is because the population base of India is very high. So, per capita GDP is GDP divided by population. So, when the base goes higher, then the value becomes smaller. So, we have a huge population base. That is why we have lesser per capita GDP. Now, per capita rank of China is 69 and India is 118 while considering the PPP. But we have seen that India is third in terms of PPP, GDP in terms of purchasing power parity. Now, inflation rate. Inflation means a consistent rise in the prices of commodities. So, inflation rate of India is 6.8% as of February 2020 and Chinese economy has an inflation rate of 3.0%, which means the rate of inflation in China is lesser than that of India. So, this is another comparison. So, inflation is also a very important macroeconomic parameter. That's why we are considering that as well. Now, look at this table where we will quickly go through the GDP comparison of both the countries. Nominal GDP rank of India is 139. Nominal GDP is, this is per capita GDP, okay. Again, it is 2.97 trillion whereas it is 14.22 trillion. GDP, PPP, purchasing power parity, you will see here the difference. China is almost double, more than double. Nominal GDP expected and GDP per capita Again, GDP growth rate. So these are various factors. Okay, various comparisons that we can make. Now let's come to business comparison. In the ease of doing business ranking, ease of doing business index is published by the World Bank, one of the most important indices. So according to the World Bank's ease of doing business, the rank of India is 53, whereas rank of China is 46. Total stock market value, again, China has almost double. 100 plus billion companies, in India it's 3, whereas in China it's 12. This can even be compared, or it can be related with that of the ease of doing business ranking. Total exports 325 billion, whereas it is 2.1 trillion. Okay. So these are some of the comparisons that we can make. Reserves. Again, we will see that China is one among the leading countries in terms of forex reserves or foreign exchange reserves. Even in terms of gold reserves, China is much ahead of India. External debt, national debt. So all these factors, we will again compare it with China. Okay, GDP growth. This is the graph with regard to the GDP growth. The green represents China and red is India. Okay, this is the India versus China by GDP. So here also we will see that the PPP, China's PPP, it's showing a steady growth, whereas in case of India, even though we can say that it's a steady growth, it's the rate of growth is very less in India. Okay, the blue one, and even the purple PPP, even though it's steady, the rate is slow. The red one, it's regarding China's nominal GDP. So here we will see the rate of growth is much higher in China as compared to India. So these are some of the comparisons between Indian economy and Chinese economy. I will see you again with another lecture. So if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe to our channel, and you can also get the information regarding our online courses through our website, or you can call to this numbers. Thank you.